Hey people, ever since this lockdown has begun, I've been making these short little videos to thank people who made a difference in my life, you know, because life is short. We don't seem to realize that. So this particular video, I just want to say that, you know, November 13th, 1999 was a day that kind of changed the lives of so many people, myself included. I mean, in terms of, you know, that was the annual sports day at St. Anne's, the school I was studied at. And my little sister, along with 17 others, were part of this closing ceremony where they had these little kids, you know, dressed as Santa Claus with the cotton, you know, raw cotton, and holding sparklers, you know, these Diwali sparklers. Now, I think, you know, during the rehearsals, we never, I was the school secretary then, you know, in back then I was in the 10th standard. So I think we didn't practice with those lighted sparklers, because on the day of the event, when the children were all dressed in these very silky sort of red Santa Claus outfits, all these kids were made to sit, like they were all crammed and sitting in this van, and sparklers were given in their hands. Now, one of the kids who was sitting in the van, they had to hold the sparklers from the windows, you know. But one of the kids brought the sparkler in, and they were all sitting crammed. So you can imagine what happened. So, I mean, I remember standing few feet away from that incident when I saw my own little sister ablaze. You know, it's one of the most, like, basically her legs, and you know, in to times like that, you're just rooted to the spot. I mean, at least for me, my brain stopped functioning, you know, when I saw that happening, because one after the other, the children started jumping out of the van, and each one had a different body part ablaze. You know, it was, I think that's what, it's been 20 years since that incident, but still when I think of it, it's, I can't, you know, speak of it without getting emotional. So, the reason I made this video is, that's what, once my sister jumped out, luckily my parents were in the audience, and I just remember my dad carrying my sister and running to the nearest, there was this hospital called Basan Sahani that was close to St. Anne's, you know, the school. So we went running there, and there, luckily, there was another child who had reached there by car or whatever and had been admitted. And this kid was, her name was Kanika, you know, Kanika Kumar. And I still remember I was also in that little room where, you know, they were, the patients were being admitted. And this child who had far, like, she literally had a lot of, you know, my little sister got burnt in the legs, and this kid, she was this cute petite, she is this cute petite little girl, so she suffered far greater burns. But if there's something called grace under pressure, this small child in her state where she's all, you know, suffering these burns, she stops to ask my dad, "Uncle, how is Ashita?" You know, I've heard of grace under pressure in terms of when you read it in books and things like that, but to hear that little 11-year-old, you know, ask someone, like, in a very, she was genuinely concerned how her classmate was. So really, I mean, like, as of yesterday, I was reading this book by this Japanese healer. It's called Healing Power. This Japanese writer called Ryoho Okawa. So he says the people who are the real winners in life are the ones who, regardless of their own health issues or troubles, stop to find out about someone else, stop to help someone else. So for a lifetime, Kanika, thank you. I mean, it was my little sister involved, but that's what, for me, I've yet to have this experience of anyone else putting aside their own, at the moment, the kind of crisis they are in, to inquire and find out how someone else is doing. So it's a salute. I mean, I couldn't make this video without getting emotional, but truly, yeah, if there's anything called grace under pressure, I witnessed it that day when this 11-year-old named Kanika was in that tiny little hospital room with us. This is, it's so, so on that note, thanks for watching and please subscribe. I cannot bring myself to give this video a logical end because, my God, I've gone back in time and it'll take me some time to recover, I guess. But seriously, Kanika, big salute.